Sequencing the human genome began as a laborious worldwide project. To sequence and analyze a genome is different today. As Wu Feng points out in his classroom lectures, the time needed for the task has been compressed from weeks to minutes, and the cost has dropped from $95 million to $6,000. Computer scientists like Feng are all about speed. For example, one molecular modeling application was taking more than 10 hours to compute, but by
co-designing the software and the algorithms together, running on the same hardware, we're able to extract the parallel computing performance out of that hardware device and get the performance from taking 10 hours down to half a second.
The work has application to any problem requiring massive amounts of computing and data processing capabilities. Better healthcare is one of the goals, with treatments being tailored to the genetic makeup of the patient. Scientists would like to know,
why do two people, for example, with the same affliction, when they have the same treatment, they have different outcomes? And there's a personalized medicine aspect to that as well.
Along with other Virginia Tech researchers, Feng attended a Virginia Tech event in Newport News to explain his work to representatives of industry. We've come a long way since Rosalind Franklin's famous X-ray diffraction images leading to the discovery of the molecular structures of DNA. Scientists are
also doing computational fluid dynamics on cars, race cars, or jets, or fighter planes, or little mini drones. There's work on reverse engineering the brain.
What he's talking about is really a new frontier for science in general, this idea of using cloud computing and really expanding our computing capabilities, high-performance computing, to attack some of the problems that we have that really require that level of computation, that level of storage of information. So we are at a frontier now where we're starting to be able, because of the cloud and computing capability in general, to tackle problems that would have been impossible in the past.
For Outreach and International Affairs, this is Andrea Brunet reporting.